Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Ray Dolan coming to you live on St. Patrick's Day, and we have got our own parade, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, the College Veilers are going to parade up here for us live on the street, ladies and gentlemen. So, for no further ado, we're going to continue and start off with the College Veilers and their parade. Here we go. If it'll come in. Here we go. Yes, indeed. And starting off the parade, we have Haley and Lily. And behind, we have Holly. And who is that? Alex, that's right. And behind them, give us a boop there. That's a lucky dude. That's Andre, or is it? No, it's Oscar. Andre in the back there, doing a bit of juggling. And Lily, the organizer of the parade here today. Ladies and gentlemen, doing a fantastic job. Sorry, Maddie, I got the names wrong. And in the background, coming up behind. Yes, look, it's written on these. Magnificent piece of work. Information on St. Patrick's Day. Oh, from Ray and the College Veilers. I like that. Well done, well done. Dylan, any words of wisdom for us? And we've got a new guy here. What's your name? Marco. And that's it, they're moving along. We've lost one flag already, but we're heading. It's going very well, this parade. Excellent, we'll just try and catch up with the rest of them here in the College Veilers. It's their second time to be back live with us. Coming down, and as you can see, they're on their way. Bells are ringing. Some excitement here in the estate. And yes, indeed. Fantastic. Well, well done, well done. And that's the end of our parade, but not exactly. Hello, hello, hello. Now, let's say hello to you. Hello, my dear. How's it going?
Good.
Are you enjoying St. Patrick's Day?
Yeah.
Who is this young man here?
What's your name?
Alex. Alex. So, we have our organiser, Maddie. I got your name wrong a few minutes ago. Sorry about that. Maddie, a lot of organisation to the parade this year.
Yeah.
A lot of face painting. Who done the face painting?
My mum.
Your mum. She's very, very good at it. This man, Andre, you're doing an absolute fantastic job there. Really, really good. And we've got St. Patrick here. That is a great one. That's Oscar. Give us a... Excellent, excellent. And we have all our gang here. And just once again, let's have a little look here. What's written on this? St. Patrick was born in Wales. Oh, this is the full story. Well, we're going to get the full story because we bring everyone on board the bus. Will you like to come on board the bus? Okay, well, we're going to bring them all on board the bus, folks, and we're going to have a tune from the College Veilers. That we're very, very lucky to have them once again, the College Veilers, on board the bus. So if we can get them all on board there, in you go, guys. Yes, the College Veilers, a very, 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 very important group of kids down here. So, yes, all on board, yes, all on board. They're going to sing us a tune on board the bus. In you go, yes indeed, I hope's enough seats for everyone. Just move everything away there, please. Excellent, excellent. Now, brilliant job. We're doing a fantastic job here now. Excellent. But very, very good indeed. There's, yeah, okay, okay, right. Super duper. As you can see, there's the College Veilers. You remember them from their Christmas tour. But this time they're all in their traditional Irish colours. And they're with us once again on the bus. So... Well, you know, I think it'll be open. Leave it, it'll close there anyway. It's only half closed, but it just needs for that much.
Okay.
Okay. Right then, so we're going to have a tune. Is that right, from the College Veilers?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Well, the first one we're going to do is this magnificent tune here. It's called Ireland's Call. Is there many rugby fans on board the bus?
Yeah.
Okay, well, keep an eye here on the music. Right on. I want to hear you singing loud and clear. Signal. Here we go. And you see the words.
Proud promises.
Ireland's call from all the College Vailers. And I'm going to try and do something with my phone because I'm sort of half caught here, but not to worry. So we're going to have our friends to tell us about St. Patrick and the St. Patrick story. Have we got someone from the group who's going to chat about the story of St. Patrick? Okay. Brilliant. We'll put this in here. Excellent. Now we're sorted. So, start off. Who's going to start off the story of St. Patrick? Okay. Okay, the story of St. Patrick. What happened with him? Where did he go? Who's got the piece of paper? It was on the bike.
It's outside on the skiers.
Not to worry. Anyway, we're going to keep moving. Anyway, what else have we got? We've got Ireland's Call. You know it?
Yeah.
Okay, Maddie, you give us the story of St. Patrick.
So St. Patrick was born in Wales and he was kidnapped as a young boy. He used to dream like every night that he'd go back to Wales and reunite with his family. And then one night it came true and a man came and brought him on a boat back to Wales. After he wanted to become a priest, so he became a bishop. And he came back to Ireland and he became, and he, and he came, and then he came back to Ireland and he was like a bishop and he built a lot of Christian churches around Ireland and stuff. And he drew like the snakes out of Ireland, but people say it's not actually snakes, it was actually the bad people. He drew like the snakes out of Ireland, like the bad people.
Excellent.
That wanted to hurt people.
And all them buildings are still there, aren't they?
Yeah, they're still there and he's born. And he is buried up in Antrim, I think, or Armagh.
That's right, yeah.
And he died at age 46.
On March 17th.
Really?
Yeah, that's why it's St. Patrick's Day.
I didn't know it was his birthday.
That's why it's on St. Patrick's Day. That's when he died.
Brilliant. Right, what else have we got here? We have Lily to tell us a story here about her uncle. Is that right, Lily?
Yeah.
And we have some video footage here as well of let me see, where is it gone? Oh, let me see, have I got it? No. I have it maybe here somewhere. Not to worry. Where is it gone? Yes, there it is. Okay, stay with me now. We're flying along here nicely. And we have some video footage. Where is it? Here it is. And hold up all the people who are looking in from all over the world. Hello to you all, folks. As I said, we're running a big show here in a huge organization of kids. So let me go back here to the beginning of this. Wow, there's wind out there. It's raining.
That felt like a rocket ship.
Okay, so we're going to turn around the information here and just show you the video here of what's your uncle's name again?
Jay.
That's right, and there he is there, look. So this is some of the footage. This is a Mullingar filmmaker and he's making this movie at the moment. Things are, oh, he's not in good shape in that one. What's it about, the movie?
God's in the Fighting Men.
Right, and there he's in bad shape in that one, but it says he's going to come up. But so there's a lady actually in this as well, so we'll bring you back to the lady. He's reaching out for her, and there she is. She's after a beer. To see her. Excellent. And there he is. It's called God's Fighting Men. And that's just a little preview we have, ladies and gentlemen. And we have Maddie here, and she's going to tell us a little bit more about the story. Lily, beg your pardon, Lily Millie.
This is my uncle's book. He also made a book about it. This is the first book, and I haven't got to read it yet, but there's pictures at the back.
All right.
Like, someone, I think, drew them for him.
Oh,
it's
wow.
Pieces of the book.
And is this going to be on Netflix and all them type of things?
Don't have a clue.
No, not yet, anyway. He was chatting to us on the bus and he was saying about the, oh wow, magnificent. And he's got actors and all coming from all over the world to join him on this project. And things have sort of slowed up slightly for him at the moment with the way things have changed in the last year. But he's still trooping on and he made this book especially to keep people interested and show them what a great, great project it's going to be. It's going to be over a load of series all... mainly on Netflix, I think, and probably one of the Hollywood stations as well. He's chatting to them. So, brilliant. So that's super job, Lily. And thank you very, very much for that. And who else have we got here, folks? Let me see. We've got something else going on here. We have our next tune is coming up and it's called... Yes?
I'm just going to put this
here. Leave that there. We'll leave that there. Excellent. And our next song is going to be called The Galway Girl. Does everyone know this one?
Yeah.
Here we go. Are you ready? Here we go. Sang by all our friends on the bus. We have to continue our show. We have, listen, there's great shouts from all the neighbours looking in. Woohoo! And we have the next part of our show is we have Oscar with a poem. And Oscar, the last time at Christmas he was on board the bus, and I think he done another poem for us at Christmas as well. Good man, Oscar. Great to have you on board once again. Excellent.
A leprechaun is small and green. He hides where he cannot be seen. If you find him on this very day, he must give all of his gold away.
Hooray! Give a big round of applause. Oscar once again comes up, trumps on board the bus. So, what else are we to do?
Play games.
Yeah. Play games. Yeah, well, we've lots of people looking in here. Tell me, can I sing a song?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Okay, then. So let me see. Will we do... I think we'll do this one. If we can find it. Let me see. Yeah?
Alex wants to say hi.
Yeah, he's very welcome. Where is he?
He's right here. He's coming down.
Alex. Hello.
Look up.
Look up.
Look up.
You're on television. You say hello to everyone out there. Fair play to you, Alex. You're a star. Thank you. Now, who else we got here? Oh, yes. Here's the song. You know this one? In an evening. Have we tried for another song maybe? Yes, we could do this one. This is a song, a Westmead song, and you might know this one. Woohoo! Any Irish dancers?
No. Sure, I am a Westmead bachelor, and my age is 103. I don't intend to marry or to raise a family. Sure, I'm happy and contented to live a single life. And that's the reason why I don't intend to take a wife. With the rest of on her fingernails and varnish on her toes. Her rattle and her ulcers all and whitewash on her nose. You get a fancy barber to shave her neck or head. And that's why I'm a bachelor and I don't intend to wed. Woo! A diddly-a-da-da, the other day at the market in the town of Mullingar, a friend he introduced me to a famous movie star. She's married several times before to men of every breed, and she thought she had a sucker in the bachelor whom I have made. With her rest of on her fingernails and varnish on her toes, her rattle and her ulcers all and whitewash on her nose. She get a fancy barber to shave her neck or head. And that's why I'm a bachelor and I don't intend to wed. Woo! The other day at the market in the town of Mullingar, a friend introduced me to a famous movie star. She's married several times before to men of every breed, and she thought she had a sucker in the bachelor from his feed. With the rest of on her fingernails and varnish on her toes, her rattle and her elf's hog and whitewash on her nose, she can get a fancy barber to shave her neck or head. And that's why I'm a bachelor and I don't intend to wed. That's why I'm a bachelor and I don't intend to wed.
There's this song about Mullingar and it's called This Town.
Oh, This Town, yeah.
Yeah. I wonder if we do that.
Oh, well, I haven't called it up, so we can't do it at the moment. But not to worry, we're going to do this one here, maybe. I haven't done this in a while. It's a very old song, this one. It's a green song. It's from Johnny Cash.
I close my eyes and picture the emeralds of the sea, from the fishing boats at Dingle to the shores of Dunedin. I miss the River Shannon and the folks at Skibbereen, the moorlands and the meadows and their 40 shades of green. Most of all, I miss the girls in Tipperary town.